Hello, I'm Jamie. Welcome to another session of Vrayzdepth Support Services. In this particular exercise, we're just going to take users through the quick process of adding the depth of field effect into a finished image like this. I've rendered this using Vray, and for me to achieve this final result, I've used a photo reference as previously done on other tutorials. I'm currently using Adobe CC 2018, so for me to add the depth of field accurately, I need the Zdepth map from Vray. So to do so, I'm simply going to go into 3ds Max. Because we're doing some test renders, we're going to ensure that the output size is really low. And we're also going to disable the global illumination because we don't need it. In here, we're just going to add the vrayzdepth map element, which is there. So you just scroll down. So by default, the minimum value is 0, which is this one, and the maximum is 500 meters. So let's just do a quick test render to see what it looks like. So at the moment, it looks a bit washed out. So we're just going to click cancel there. Go back to render element, reduce the that value from 500 to say 16.5. And let's see what it looks like. So he's looking much better now. You can clearly see the dark and the bright areas, and there's a gradient there. So this should be a really good map. So once you're happy with your results, you just click render. You cancel that first. Increase your values there. Enable the GI. And the final result should look something similar to this. This is like 3000 pixels. We're back in Photoshop. Just bring in your pre-rendered vrayzdepth render element there. What you do, you duplicate that layer, you bring it into the main document, which is the Atrium Night PSD. Close that. That's the layer that's just been pre-rendered. So the next thing that we're going to do is to just save the selection so we can use it in order to achieve the depth of field effect. While that's selected, we go to channels, hold down the control key. On the RGB thumbnail, you just click. So the selection should be on. We're going to go to select, save the selection, and let's call the selection DOF, depth of field. Okay. You can delete this particular layer now. To deselect, you just click the control key and D, so it's deselected. It's always good practice not to work on the main layer, so you're just going to duplicate, right click, duplicate, there. So now we're going to add the depth of field effect. So you go to filter and choose the lens blur effect there. See, by default, Photoshop just automatically knew that that was the map that was saved just now, the DOF. Otherwise, you'd have used none. But because we saved it before, he's looking into that depth of field map. So you don't want that to be too high, so we're just going to reduce it to, say, 30. It's a good starting point. So in the Iris group, we can just set the type of depth of field that we want. So we got the triangle, just like there. We got the square, pentagon, which is five different angles there. I really prefer to use the pentagon. And you can set the number of the radius as well. 40 obviously being very small. 90 seems to be a very good size. And you can rotate it or not. What he does is simply rotates the blade. The pentagon has five corners, so by increasing the curvature, you're actually making that pentagon a bit more rounded. Instead of having five corners, you might end up with 21 corners. Essentially, it's very, very round, so we can reduce that. So I think it looks much better with five corners there, as you can see here. And in here, you get the speculum highlights. So I normally have the brightness set really, really high. And then with the threshold, I can control the brightness. So the higher you go, the less bright that will look. I often have the threshold to about 190, so it's almost as bright as everything around it. So the lower we go, the less the areas will be affected by it. So essentially it's just focusing on the brighter areas of the map that we pre-saved. So that's the map that Photoshop is looking at. So the areas being affected are these ones here, as you can see. If you go back into Photoshop, so these are the areas being affected by it. And you can always reduce the blur focal distance. So once you're satisfied with the results, you just click OK. And this is the before and after. So this concludes our tutorial, and I hope you like it. If you do, please click the like button, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.